Well, that's the word coming in from a whole host of corporates that we spoke to earlier in the day. But now let's invite one more on our show. Praveen Sood, the CFO of HCC, joins us now on the sidelines from the Anand Rathi Emerging India Conference that is currently underway. Mr. Sood, good afternoon and thank you for speaking with us. You know, the biggest problem for many companies like yourselves, good afternoon, sir, has been the weakness that you've seen in the top line. So even in the quarter gone by, your income was down about 8%. In the quarter before that, the income was down about 3%. And in all of FY15, we haven't seen much of a recovery. Has there been any respite to the execution problems that companies such as yours have faced? And when do you think we could expect to see a considerable pickup in the top line or the revenues?
Yeah, I think the entire sector has seen this. I mean, whatever results has been come so far, I mean, has shown that every company in the sector has seen some declining in the top line. Whereas the, I think the silver lining has always been that the margin has not shrank and margins has improved overall. And I think we also continues to have a margin which is much better. I would not like to blame execution problem to the declining top line. It's mainly on account of non-receipt of order for almost now 1.5 years. The pipeline for order inflow has been very, very slow in the last 1.5 years when the government change took place. And normally all infra projects normally which get announced by the government, they have basically a lag time of almost close to about say 9 months to 1 year before they start operating. So we are in the same gap. Hopefully, I think you will find once the order which we have received there basically start executing them, the bottom line and top line both will improve significantly. But okay, we have to still give them time for about maybe say another 3 to 6 months time.
Okay, Mr. Sood, good afternoon. So what's the what's the status on the recovery of the outstanding claims? I believe it's almost 4,000 crores now from various government agencies.
We have lodged claims worth about 10,000 crore, far above 4,000 crore, which you are just seeing. However, we have been able to get the award in our favor to the extent of close to about now 2,400 crores. So it's a process by itself. First of all, we have to lodge our claim, then basically they go for arbitration. Arbitration, normally award comes and comes in our favor or against us.
Oops, okay. We'll just go back to that when we can resume that link. But that's the word coming in from HCC. Issues with respect to non-receipt of orders, slower order wins is what's actually impacted their revenue line quite a bit. This stock has been under intense pressure. It's down about more than 30% for the year. But on the flip side, let's tell you about a couple of stocks that are doing very well this afternoon. The entire pharma space is now up, up and away. And all of these stocks that I'm mentioning, names like Glenmark, Aurobindo, Dishman, Divi's Labs, are all hitting fresh 52-week highs. So that is actually the space to be in this afternoon. But let's try and resume our conversation with Mr. Sood. Mr. Sood, sorry, you were telling us about the recovery of the overdue claims. You said 2,400 crores is how much you've received so far. Is that correct?
Not received. Basically, we have received the award in our favor. So it's a process. I mean, you know, first of all, there's a dispute between us and client, and normally which goes for arbitration, and arbitration award comes, and then normally clients go and challenge this into the courts, and then court basically release payment. But once we receive the award, we are certain that amount, same amount would be received by us along with the interest. So more or less once the award comes in our favor, it clearly indicates that we are due to receive this money, I mean, maybe in a couple of years' time.
Okay, but what about your balance sheet repairment issues, Mr. Sood? Of course, you had that Lavasa IPO, but after that, we haven't really seen any major moves. You have very high outstanding debt. Any plans to pare down on that debt?
I mean, we are moving in this direction. In fact, the last quarter just gone by, the Q1 basically has some significant changes which we have done in the balance sheet. One was doing a QIP of 400 crore, which the money has come, and at least significant part of the money has gone to repay the debt. And then recently, you must have heard, in the month of July, we did the sale of our 247 park, which was parked in a company called HREL. So these two things have happened this quarter, and other repair will happen once we start receiving our claims. So hopefully we are planning to receive a large amount of claims this year, which are in the arbitration at this point of time. Award has come in our favor. So hopefully a large part will be able to realize this year. and this entire money will go towards repayment of debt. So, I mean, the process is painfully slow, but since we are dealing with the legal system, we are dealing with the courts and all those things, this is bound to take some time. But we are on the course, we are moving, in the right direction. So I think we will see some good days ahead of us, maybe, if not this year, maybe I think I'm very sure in the year 16-17.
So can you quantify that for us by the end of, say, FY16 or even FY17, in the next 2 years, how much could you pare down your debt? What does it stand at currently?
See, currently we are close to about 4,800 crores. In fact, we were at 5,000 crore in the beginning of the year. By using QIP money, we have gone down by almost 250 crores roughly. And we expect that maybe in coming, say, 12 to 18 months, we'll bring it down further by close to about 1,000 crore further down. This is our plan. And okay. I think so far, I mean, we are making good progress toward our plan. So, but since we are dealing with the court, any timeline and certainty, I mean, I cannot say with surety. But since we are moving as per the directions what we have fixed for ourselves, I feel, I think, 12 to 18 months, we would be down by close to about 1,000 crore.
What is the latest on Lavasa issue? You know, I spoke about the fact that you tried to do IPO earlier, but it's been the longest pending issue now. What's the latest update?
We have all the approvals, but unfortunately, the real estate market continues to remain into the problem. I think whatever IPOs started coming in the recent past, they are coming from the different sector. Not the single IPO has come into the either infrastructure or the real estate sector. I think there's no appetite in the market for the real estate stock at this point of time. And so that's why we are, I think, finding it a little challenging to do the IPO in the moment. But our all the BRMs, which are basically the top-notch BRMs at this point of time, they are working towards it. And hopefully, I think we should be able to do something if the appetite for the real estate or the infra stocks increases in the future.
Okay. You were telling us about the sale of your stake in 247 Park for 160 crores. What are the other non-core assets that you have that you're looking to monetize and reduce your debt?
We have two more assets which we have announced the deal. One was our one BOT assets in Andhra Pradesh called Nirmal BOT. The other one which we have announced is our Dhule Palesnar road, which is along with Sadbhav. So these two assets also we have sold. We were basically in the last leg of completing the legal formalities and the documentation, and the money should flow in by this quarter, hopefully. Then, of course, we have a few more BOT projects, which we are trying to complete first before we put them onto the block for sale. And maybe I think you will find that they would be mostly completed by the end of this year. So hopefully, I think the January March quarter, you will find one more sale happening on this line. So these are the few assets which we are trying to sell.
On the BOT projects in particular, how are things now? Do you think the worst is over? Of course, things will not be back to the peak, but in terms of the current status of things, what's your call? Do you think the worst is truly over?
It's very difficult to say worst is fully over or not, because in fact we are still, BOT projects are doing fine as far as the revenues are concerned. I mean, traffic is slightly improving, and I think we have the projects, I mean, barring one project, most of the projects are basically running on, as per the traffic norm which we have used for funding the projects. So not much, but I think we can still see that. I think maybe give it a couple of more months, and I think the traffic will improve further. Economy is now reeling back to, normal self and all those things. So hopefully, I think give it another 3 to 6 months, and I think BOT projects will start doing fine. However, I think most of the bankers who have funded these projects, not of ours but other projects also, where there are delays and they are not being able to get completed, there we are still struggling because the land issues are still there. There are some other issues which is coming on the way of completion of these projects. So I think we have to wait for another 6 months, I think, to make sure that the completion time and the traffic also, both of them basically help us to achieve what we have now planned in the beginning.
Okay, so just before we let you go, Mr. Sood, you know, you started off by telling us that the non-receipt of orders is what's actually impacted your top line and orders are just not coming through. You have an exposure to various states, you know, Uttarakhand, Andhra Pradesh, Assam, West Bengal. Geography-wise, where are you seeing the slowest movement of orders and where are you seeing any signs of sort of green shoots or any pickup in activity, if you could just tell us?
Instead of geography, I think we are more concerned of the areas where we work on. In fact, we target four areas where normally we work, where we get the maximum order. The most significant part of order book basically comes from the hydropower, which is exactly causing us a lot of problems because this sector is not moving at all. I mean, we don't see a huge amount of pipeline also in this sector, mainly because of the environmental issues and basically the this entire sector is not moving at all.
Sure.
And then come down to the water sector, which is basically the irrigation sector, which used to be happen in Andhra and the Telangana, of course. These two states have just had elections, and I think some work is happening, but the pace is still not come, and we didn't see much order coming in this sector. Then come down to transport sector, where we are seeing some movement, railways, transport sector. Mm-hmm. Here the movement is fine, and I think most of my orders has come from this sector. And then fourth area where we work heavily is the nuclear power and the fabrication work and the industrial work. Again, that area is very, very slow. So barring transport area, I think we are not seeing much action in three areas. Having said that, we have been able to notch close to about 3,000 crore worth of 11 positions in the quarter one of this fiscal year. However, we are still not been able to convert those orders, convert those 11 positions into the firm order and start the work, mainly because of certain issues which are lying with them. So again, a cause for concern that even when you become L1, we did our part, but due to some restrictions, some environment clearances, some approvals, the order doesn't turn into the normally the work flow start.
All right, Mr. Sood, appreciate your time and we wish...